The long history is the young man's name up there, Jim Steinman, had the idea of doing a musical in college when he was in Amherst. And the name of the play back then was Dream Engine. Now, he got Joe Papp, who was the biggest producer in New York, and maybe the biggest producer ever. I don't know in the early 30s or 40s if there was a bigger producer. All I know is the 60s, 70s, 80s, 90s, until he passed away in like 2007. He was the biggest producer on Broadway, from Lincoln Center to the Public Theater, New York Shakespeare Festival, Chorus Line, on and on, just endless. And so he went to see the play, Dream Engine, and put Steinman on salary at the Public Theater when Jim graduated. And I went to New York to do hair in 69, about the time Jim was doing his play. And 2 years later, I got an agent, and he said, if you want to work, if you want to be a working actor in New York, you have to work for Joe Papp. So I went down, auditioned for Steinman. He said, wait here, brought in 40 people. I sing about four notes. Joe Papp handed me a script, and in the script was one song, which wasn't in the script, but was added, which was Steinman. And it was the first time I ever got a standing ovation for anything, and the first time that any Jim Steinman song had got that kind of reaction. And so that's kind of how we got together. And then Lou Adler, who was the producer of the Rocky Horror Show, Jim came out to the opening, and Lou Adler said, if you two don't work together, then you're out of your minds. And we did, and Bat Out of Hell came about. But this has been a 50-year dream for Jim Steinman. Now, can you imagine having a dream for 50 years finally come true? How you must feel. It must not feel real to him, and it makes me cry because he is my friend and I love him so much that to sit here and see this is unbelievable.